So look with now, this is the last topic of this class, energy level diagrams for molecular orbitals. Okay, ab jab hum log energy level diagrams karenge, to stabilities we have already done ki energy level diagram ki stabilities kis tarah se hoti hai. The bonding they are at lower energy levels than the atomic orbitals, so they are going to be more stable, while the antibonding they are at a higher energy level than the atomic orbitals, they are going to be less stable. Okay. Now we have two types of molecular orbitals, one is bonding and one is antibonding. We say that if number of orbital number of electrons in bonding that is greater than number of electrons in antibonding, okay, then the molecule is stable. Why? Because the bond order in this case that will become equal to positive. Okay? Number two, if the number of orbitals in bonding is less than number of orbitals in antibonding, then the molecule is unstable or it does not exist. Or it does not exist. ठीक है? फिर number three, if number of orbitals in bonding is equal to number of orbitals in antibonding, right? Then in that case again the bond order over here that will become equal to zero, right? And the molecule is again unstable. Okay. Now when we are talking of orbitals, we say that all these molecular orbitals they are filled up with electrons with all the same rules which are followed for atomic orbitals. Like for example, the first rule which we follow is Pauli's exclusion principle, that each of the orbital cannot accommodate more than two electrons, and that too with opposite spins. So same we will see it will be followed over here. Then second, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. So Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity kya bolta hai? That says that pairing will not take place in a set of degenerate orbitals until each orbital is singly fit. ठीक है? And number three, off-bar principle, that the electrons they are filled up in order of increasing energies. So all those rules which we follow for filling up of atomic orbitals, they all we are going to follow over here. Okay. So यहाँ पे भी जो energy रहती है, that is 1s will have the lowest energy. So 1s में we know that we have two types of orbitals. One is bonding and the other one is antibonding. So first we are going to fill up the bonding and then we go on to antibonding. Similarly, then we have 2s bonding, 2s antibonding. So we will fill up first 2s bonding and then 2s antibonding. When we are going to the p orbital, we say that p subshell has three orbitals, px, py, and pz. Okay? Over here, px that is going to form pi. Okay? We have discussed this also. It is going to form pi, and over here also it is going to form pi, and pz that is going to form sigma 2pz. Right? Now 2px and pi 2py, they have same energy. They have the same energy. So they are said to be a set of degenerate orbitals. Okay? They are said to be a set of degenerate orbitals. The energy of 2pz may vary for different molecules. Right? So let's take the examples over here of the two kind of arrangements of energy level diagrams which we have. When we are talking of molecules of say Li2 positive, right? And we have Be2 positive, and then we have carbon C2 and फिर उसके बाद we have carbon के बाद carbon से पहले we have B2, then we have C2 and then we have N2. The following energy level diagram is for all these molecules. ठीक है? So in this 1s that is going to come at the bottom most position because of lowest energy. But over here bonding we are going to show only in the valence shell. 1s and 2s, they have the same kind of representation, right? So we are saying that energy over here is increasing, right? So we have 2s, this is 2s. Now 2s, it is going to overlap to give us sigma 2s and sigma antibonding 2s. Okay? So this is 2s, this is also 2s, this is sigma 2s and this is sigma antibonding 2s. When we go to P, we have 3 orbitals of P. ये आ गया और उसी तरह से यहां पे भी वी हैव 3 ऑर्बिटल्स ऑफ पी. ठीक है. नाउ इन केस ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल स्टिल नाइट्रोजन पाई इज गोइंग टू बी एट अ लोअर एनर्जी लेवल. ठीक है. एंड देन सिग्मा और फिर उसके बाद pi and then sigma. ठीक है. So this is going to be the energy level over here up to oxygen when we are up to nitrogen molecule when we are talking of. We are going to first fill pi and then we are going to fill z. ठीक है. और फिर उसके बाद again we have pi antibonding and then we have z antibonding.
Pi to P X, pi to P Y 2. Sigma
here. Right, so this is 2P. This is also 2P. Okay, this is going to be pi 2P X by antibonding, pi 2P Y and sigma 2pz. ठीक है. ये आ गया पाए एंटीबॉन्डिंग 2py, पाए एंटीबॉन्डिंग 2px, पाए एंटीबॉन्डिंग 2py एंड सिग्मा एंटीबॉन्डिंग 2pz. राइट. नाउ व्हेन वी आर टेकिंग, लेट्स टेक द मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ नाइट्रोजन ओवर हियर. द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन दैट इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू व्हाट? 1s2, 2s2, 2p3, right? So in 2s there are 2 electrons. So this is how we will fill 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? In p we have 3 electrons over here and we have 3 electrons over here. So we have to fill 6 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. ठीक है. When we looking at the bond order over here, we know that bond order that is equal to number in bonding minus number in antibonding divided by 2. Right? So a bonding में कितने हैं? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in bonding. So 8 minus 2 in antibonding divided by 2. That becomes equal to 3. So the bond order of N2 molecule that is going to be equal to 3. Okay. How do we write down the electronic configuration over here? Electronic configuration will be written as KK dash. KK dash is the electronic configuration for 1s. Jaise for example, when we are doing the electronic configuration for atomic orbitals, in that case, what do? We write the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas in brackets. ठीक है. सो ऐसे यहाँ पे 1s की जो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन है, वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इट एज 1s. ओके. सो लेट्स आफ्टर दैट वी हैव सिग्मा 2s2, सिग्मा एंटीबॉन्डिंग 2s2 एंड देन वी हैव पाई 2px1, पाई 2px2, पाई 2px2, पाई 2py2 and we have sigma 2p z2. This is going to be the electronic configuration. Right? Now over here you can see that all the electrons, they are paired. Therefore we say that the molecule of nitrogen is diamagnetic. Diamagnetic ka matlab kya hua? Ki they are going to be repelled by the magnetic field. They are going to be repelled by the magnetic field. Okay? That is diamagnetic substances. Or diamagnetism kis liye hota hai? Because of all paired number of electrons. Now over here we have to talk of different kind of molecules. Depending upon the number of electrons, we have to see whether what is going to be the bond order and what is going to be the magnetic character. So the first species which we have done over here is that of nitrogen. The second one, N2 positive. Okay? Third one is N2 negative and N2 2 negative. Right? Now the number of electrons in this case is 14. Number of electrons in this case is going to be 13. Number of electrons in this case is going to be 15. And number of electrons in this case, that is going to be 16. Okay? Now, how will we calculate the bond order over here? Bond order for this, that is equal to, there are how many electrons in the bonding? 8. Right? So, we have 8 minus 2 divided by 2, that is going to be 3. When we go to less number of electrons, the antibonding electrons, because they are on the outer side, they are going to be affected over here. So the bond order in this case, that will be equal to what? When we are talking of one electron less. So if there is one electron less over here, one electron will be less in the bonding also. So we have 7 minus 2 divided by 2. That will come to 2.5. Okay? Now when we are going to 15, N2 negative 15 electrons, one electron that will come over here. Okay? So if one electron that is coming over here, then in that case, what is going to be the bond order? 15 ke liye, 7 minus 3 divided by 2. So we have 7 minus 3 divided by 2. 7 minus 3 is 4 divided by 2, that is going to come to 2. ठीक है और 16 के लिए हम लोगों ने पिछले वाले उसमें किया था कि अगर 16 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है तो देन व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी द बॉन्ड ऑर्डर 16 मींस वी हैव वन मोर ओवर हियर राइट सो 8 minus 3 5 8 minus 3 दैट इज गोइंग टू बी 5 So 5 is going to be again what? It is going to be 2.5. Yahan pe 8 aana tha. 2.5 aayega. Aur next wale mein hamare paas aayega. It is going to be 8 minus 3. 8 hi hoenge na? N2 2 negative hai na. So we have 1 electron here. 16 electrons we have to fill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay? S value bhi the na usme. So now over here we are going to have 8. We have how many in the bonding? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 over here in the empty bonding. So it is 8 minus 4 divided by 2. That is going to be equal to 2. Okay? Now what does bond order give us? Bond order says, number 1, we have already started this. Greater the value of bond order, greater is going to be the bond dissociation energy. Okay? So bond order is directly proportional to bond dissociation energy. Okay? Greater the bond order, greater the bond dissociation energy. Number 2, greater the bond order, greater is going to be the stability. Okay? So if we are going to take a trend of this, we are going to arrange them in increasing order of bond stability or increasing order of stability all these molecules, then what is going to be the increasing order? The least is N2-2 negative, ठीक है? फिर उससे ज़्यादा आ गया N2 negative, which is equal to N2 positive and N2. The greatest stability will be of N2. This is the kind of questions which you will get in your competitions. Okay, so you have to remember that greater the bond order, greater is going to be the stability. Okay, now when we are going to oxygen, in case of oxygen, we are going to have a little different diagram of this. So let's see about oxygen over here. You can see that 2pz is at a higher energy level, right? In case of oxygen, 2pz is going to be at a lower energy level. So oxygen and fluorine, that is molecules above nitrogen, in that 2pz is going to have a lower energy, and pi 2px and pi 2py, they are going to have higher energies. But fluorine jo hota hai, it accommodates both type of arrangements. So oxygen is very stubborn about that. It is only going to follow the second kind of arrangement. Okay, so let's go on to oxygen. When we are talking for oxygen molecule, the energy level diagram is going to be same for 2s. This is P. So over here we are saying that sigma 2pz is at a lower energy level. Then after that pi. Then the upper ones, they are not antibonding, do not have any difference. Antibonding remains the same. In case of oxygen, the electronic configuration is, for the outermost shell, it is 2s2, 2p4. Okay? So 2s2 means, if this is 2s, sigma 2s, sigma anti bonding 2s, okay? Then this is going to be 2p, then this is sigma 2pz, pi 2px, pi 2py, and this is pi anti bonding 2px, pi anti bonding 2py, and sigma anti bonding 2pz. Okay? So S में we have 2 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4 fill up हो गए. उसी तरह से we have 4 electrons in 1, 2p and 4 electrons in the other. So in total there are 8 electrons which have to be filled. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Right? When we are looking at the, we are calculating the bond order of oxygen will be equal to number in bonding minus number in antibonding divided by 2. Okay? So bonding mein kitne hai? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and in antibonding there are 4. So 8 minus 4 divided by 2, that is going to be 2, so oxygen has a double bond, right? When we are looking at the electronic configuration, it is going to be KK dash sigma 2s2 sigma anti bonding 2s2 sigma 2pz 2 pi 2px 2 pi 2py 2 and then we have pi antibonding 2px1 and pi antibonding 2py1. Theek hai ji? So this is the electronic configuration. Now in this case also we have to discuss the ions of O2 positive. This is known as oxygen molecule ion. The next one, that is going to be O2 negative. This is the superoxide ion. have O2 negative, which is a peroxide ion. Right? In this case, the number of electrons in O2 positive, that is going to be how much? We have how many electrons in this? 12 electrons. So 12 minus 1, that is going to be 11. 11 electrons in this, 13 electrons in this, and 14 electrons in this. Aise aayega? I was only taking the outermost shell. So if you are taking the complete, then we will have this phase. If you are also taking into consideration 1s, so then we will have 16 electrons in this. Okay, because I was taking 4 into 6 now, outermost. So 6 2s are 12. That is what we have filled up over here. Okay, but if you are taking also 8 into 2, 16, this is going to have 15, this is going to have 17, and this is going to have 18. Right? So if you are looking at the bond order, in case of oxygen, we have just discussed the bond order, that is going to be 2. In case of O2 positive, one electron will go from here. So we will have how much? In case of O2 positive, we will have 8 minus 3 divided by 2. 2.5. In case of O2 negative, we are going to have 8 minus 4, 1, 2, 5. 8 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1.5. Okay? And in case of O2 negative, 8 minus 6 divided by 2. That is going to be equal to 1. Okay? So when we are looking at the magnetic and paramagnetic character over here, when we are talking of O2 positive, it is going to have oxygen, it's paramagnetic because it has unpaired electrons. Then O2 positive will also have one unpaired electron. So this is going to be paramagnetic. Okay? Then after that, O2 negative. O2 negative will also be paramagnetic because of presence of one unpaired electron in this. And O2 negative, that is going to be dimagnetic because of all paired electrons. Paramagnetic character means over here that they have unpaired electrons and they will be attracted by the magnetic field. Now, order of stability kya hogi yahan pe? O2 positive will have the maximum stability because of largest bond order. Theek hai? Phir uske baad O2 ke baad O2 negative, and the least stability will be for O2 negative. So this is all about the chapter over here, molecular orbital theory. Or we say chemical bonding. We have finished with this chapter, chemical bonding. The next chapter which we are going to start, that is states of matter.